what we now call the liberal establishment used fascists and local despots liberally to prop up the so-called Western way of life. Global capitalism in 2008 had its 1929 moment. This combination of socialism for the very, very, very few and stringent austerity for the masses did two things. First, it depressed real investment globally. At the same time, the printing presses of the central banks were creating huge quantities of cash, savings, liquidity for the rich, primarily. The result was this discontent amongst the many and the stupendous riches amongst the oligarchy. It gave rise, initially, to progressive movements, uprisings. You will remember. But they were all, one after the other, dealt with efficiently, either by the establishment directly, think of the way they crushed the Athens Spring, the Greek Spring here in the summer of 2015, or indirectly through the stagnation of global capitalism. This is, I submit to you, friends, why we need the progressive international. Because the fake opposition between the two variants of the twin authoritarianisms of the liberal establishment and of the nationalist international threaten humanity. And they threaten humanity by trapping us in a business-as-usual agenda that destroys life prospects and wastes opportunities to end climate change. Or look at the successful undermining of Jeremy Corbyn and of Bernie Sanders within their own political parties. Look at the way a veil of silence is drawn over the courageous struggles for self-determination by countless communities in Asia and in Africa. Look carefully at this multitude of defeats, and I think you will agree that the only one thing that could prevent them is an effective, well-organized progressive international. Has the time not come, friends, for progressives to emulate the bankers and the fascists in one way, to unite across borders behind a common agenda, to create a common narrative, to press our capacities into the service of the same agenda in favor of the many? This is the time.